సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేయండి అండ్ ఫర్ మోర్ అప్డేట్స్ బెల్ ఐకాన్ క్లిక్ చేయడం మర్చిపోకండి.
స్టూడెంట్స్, నౌ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ కన్స్ట్రక్షన్ వర్కింగ్ ఆఫ్ UJT. ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్, ద టర్మ్ UJT ఇస్ ద ఫుల్ ఫామ్ ఇస్ ద UJT ఇస్ ద యూని జంక్షన్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్. ఓకే, UJT ఇస్ ద యూని జంక్షన్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్. సో ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ BJT ఇస్ ద బైపోలార్ జంక్షన్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్. నెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ FET ఫీల్డ్ ఎఫెక్ట్ ట్రాన్సిస్టర్. Already we know that these two transistors. Present our topic is the unijunction transistor. So in these two transistors there are two junctions. This is also bipolar junction. This is the field effect transistor. This is also bipolar junction. But in FET there is only one majority charge carriers. So this is the unipolar field effect transistor. This is the unipolar transistor, this is the bipolar transistor. But in this also two PN junctions, in this also two PN junctions. But in UJT there is only one junction, there is only one junction. So the term UJT is the unijunction transistor. So a uni junction transistor has a only one PN junction, unlike JFET and BJT. Already we discussed JFET and BJT. So unlike JFET, BJT, so there are two PN junctions in JFET, there are two junctions in BJT. But here in UJT a uni junction, only one junction, there is only one PN junction, there is only one PN junction. So same as JFET and BJT, there are three terminals. Okay, three terminals. So there are three terminals. In three terminals, first one is emitter and second one is base, third one is base. So the unijunction transistor has two bases and one emitter, only one emitter and two base terminals. This is the unijunction transistor. This is the field effect transistor. This is also unipolar device. Unipolar device means majority charge carriers are only negative are p-type of semiconductor or n-type of semiconductor, the majority charge carriers, only one majority charge carriers, either negative or positive. So this is the field effect transistor. So the construction of UJT, the construction of UJT similar as FAT, because UJT is also unipolar junction, but in FAT there are two PN junction. This is the PN junction, this is the PN junction. In UJT there is only one PN junction diode. So this is the UJT. This is the UJT, but this is the base one. This is the base two. This is the emitter. Okay, this is the UJT, construction of UJT. Okay, in that gate surface of FET, so this is the gate, is much larger than the emitter junction. So here emitter junction is not larger of FAT of gate. Okay, in that gate surface of FAT is much larger than the emitter junction. So emitter junction is smaller than gate of FAT. Okay, next up, UJT is also different from JFET in that UJT is no. So FAT is used as amplifier. Okay, but UJT is also different from JFET in that UJT has no ability of amplifier, because JFET is voltage control device. So JFET or FAT is used as amplifier, but in UJT there is no abilities of this type, so it has no ability of amplifier. Okay, UJT is also called double base diode, because this is the B2, this is the B1, this is the emitter. So same as this is the double base diode means, so base 1, base 2, double base diode. Okay, so symbol of the UJT, what is the symbol of the UJT? So this is the symbol. This is the base one. This is the base two. But this is the emitter. So okay, totally this is the symbolic representation of UJT. UJT also called as double base diode. It also exhibits negative resistance. So it exhibits negative resistance because this causes the negative resistance characteristics it exhibits. Okay, negative characteristics which makes use as a oscillator. It is also used as oscillator. Okay, this oscillator frequency can be easily varied. So it changes very easily. So its oscillator exhibits the very easily changing frequency. So it is used as motor speed control device, because here it used as oscillator and also used as relaxation oscillator. So relaxation oscillator means it's a simplify changes of frequency. So this device control the speed. So this device is also used as motor speed control device. Okay, this is the symbolic representation. And what is the construction of UJT? UJT means uni junction transistor and also unipolar junction transistor. But FAT is also unipolar, UJT is also unipolar, but FAT has two PN junctions, UJT has only one PN junction, only one PN junction. Okay, the construction of UJT, this is the diagram of the UJT. This is the base one, B1. This is the base B2. Okay. This is the P type of semiconductor, heavily doped. This is the N type of semiconductor. Slightly doped. So this is the charge carriers, only majority charge carriers are only negative. So this is unipolar junction and also only one PN junction. So this is the unijunction transistor. Okay, first of all, the construction of UJT is similar to FAT, but FAT there is another P type of material. So UJT only one P type of material, only one charge carriers. Okay, so here N type of semiconductor used as the element silicon bar. So this silicon bar has two bases, B1 and B2. Okay, so two ohmic contacts are made at base 1 and base 2 in opposite sides of N type of semiconductor. So okay, these B1 and B2 are made of resistance. So first one is the 5k ohms, second one 10k ohms. Okay, 10k ohms, 5k ohms and 10k ohms. So this is the 5k ohms, this is the 10k ohms. Okay, these two B1 and B2 are made of a resistance of 5k omega and 10k omega. Okay, in this double base diode, this is the base 1, this is the base 2, double base, two bases, double base diode. Emitter is closer the B2. Emitter is closer the B2. So this is the emitter. So emitter is closer than closer the B2. Closer the B2 than B1. So the distance between emitter and base 1 B1 is large. The distance between emitter and base 2 is the small. So emitter is closer to B2. So this condition is the B2 is greater than B1. B2 is greater than B1. Okay. Next of all, the PN junction is formed. The PN junction is formed with heavily doped of P type of semiconductor. So here P type of semiconductor is the heavily doped. The N type of semiconductor is lightly doped. Okay. The PN junction is formed with the heavily doped P type inset near the middle of the N type of ball. So this P is the fitted in middle of the N type of ball. The P region is called emitter. The P region is called as emitter. Is formed by allowing the aluminium wire. Is connected to aluminium wire. This is the construction of UJT. This is the construction of UJT. UJT means uni junction transistor. Uni junction transistor. Okay. Next step all. Equivalent circuit of UJT. Equivalent circuit of UJT. What is the equivalent circuit of UJT? Equal physical quantities in the circuit. So this is the B1, this is the B2, this is the resistance R. First, what is the condition of UJT? The emitter is closer the B2. So this is the emitter, this is the base 1, this is the base 2, this is the emitter. Okay, this emitter is indicates this emitter. This is the point A. Okay, this is the closer the emitter, larger the emitter, the distance. Okay, in this equivalent circuit, this is the equivalent circuit. So this is the resistance R B2. This is the resistance R B1. In this equivalent circuit, point A denotes where P region is formed. P region is formed. So this is the P. So here in equivalent circuit, the point A denotes where P region is formed. Okay, the point A is such that RB2 is greater than RB1 because emitter is closer the B2. Emitter is not closer the B1. So here RB2 is greater than RB1. Here RB2, what is the RB2? Here RB2 is resistance between silicon bar between A and B2. Here RB2 is the resistance between silicon bar and A and B2. Okay, and also RB1 is resistance between silicon bar and R and B1. So the total resistance, what is the total resistance? The total resistance equals to R base equals to R B1 plus R B2. So this is the total resistance of the equivalent circuit of UJT. Okay, so the total resistance of the silicon bar from one end to another end is known as interbase resistance. This is the interbase resistance. So this is called as interbase resistance. Here the emitter acts as the potential divider. Potential divider. So the potential divider, here the resistance divider, that's the cause of the resistance divider. It's emitter acts as potential divider. Potential divider. Okay, potential divider. So this is the potential divider. Emitter is the potential divider. So the voltage division factor, this is the potential divider. So the divider is the division factor. What is the division factor? Voltage division factor is the eta. This voltage division factor is known as it's denoted by eta. Eta equals to RB1 upon RB2 plus RB1 plus RB2. Total means that eta equals to RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2 is the R at BB. Total resistance. What is the total resistance? So the resistance between R and B1, the ratio of the resistance RB1 and total resistance is called as division factor, voltage division factor. The voltage division factor is denoted by eta. Eta equals to RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2. Eta equals to RB1 upon RB1 plus RB2 is the R resistance of total resistance of base. This is the eta. This eta is the voltage division factor. Now we have to discuss the working and operation of unijunction transistor, UJT, unijunction transistor. Okay, the basic circuit operation is UJT is the, this diagram indicates the basic circuit operation of UJT. Okay, the device has normally B2 is positive with respect to B1. Okay, this device has normally B2 base 2 is positive with respect to B1. So this is the positive. Okay, next of all, if voltage base voltage, if voltage base voltage, this base voltage is denotes VBB or two bases or VB. Okay, if voltage of base is applied between B1 and B2 and emitter open, so here one condition, if emitter open, the voltage is applied between B1 and B2, that voltage is V suffix BB. Okay, then after the voltage drop is established, the voltage drop is established because here emitter is open. So the voltage drop is established. Okay, the voltage drop is established along n type of bar. This is the n type of bar. So along n type of bar, since the emitter is closer to B2. Okay, are you understand the emitter is closer to B2? What is the reason? If voltage, the base voltage is applied between B1 and B2, then emitter open. So after this condition, the voltage drop is established. Okay, after this condition, the voltage drop is established in n-type bar. So since the emitter is closer to B2. Okay, second condition. What is the condition? The voltage V1 developed across emitter and base B1. This is the voltage. This voltage is denoted as V1. Okay, the voltage V1 is developed across emitter and base 1. This voltage V1 makes a reverse bias, on the PN junction. So this is the P, this is the N. Okay, this is the P, this is the N. The voltage V1 developed across emitter and base 1. This voltage V1 makes a reverse bias on the PN junction. So this is the positive terminal, so this is the negative terminal. So this is the negative terminal, positive terminal, negative terminal, positive terminal. Okay, just like prediction. Okay, this voltage V1 makes a reverse bias on the PN junction. So small leakage current flows the emitter. Okay, so in reverse bias, so small leakage current flows to emitter, okay, current flows to emitter. If positive voltage applied at the emitter, the PN junction will remain in reverse bias. The PN junction is remains in reverse bias. So as emitter voltage is less than V1, the emitter voltage is, so this is the emitter voltage. So the emitter voltage is less than V1 because this condition, V1 is greater than VE. Okay, if positive voltage is applied at the emitter, the PN junction will remain in reverse bias. So the emitter voltage is less than V1. So this is the less, than V1. Okay, here V1 is intrinsic standoff voltage. If V1 is intrinsic standoff voltage, so this voltage V1 equals to eta into base voltage, okay, eta into base voltage. Okay, next condition, the input voltage, the input voltage to the emitter, the input voltage to the emitter exceeds V1, because exceeds V1, that means voltage emitter is greater than V1. Emitter voltage is greater than V1. So the PN junction becomes forward bias. So the forward bias is the, this is the P type of material. P type of material is connected to positive, negative, positive, negative. Okay, so this is the forward bias. So always B2 is the positive. Okay, so this is the total circuit diagram. If the input voltage VEE to the emitter exceeds V1, so the emitter voltage is greater than V1, the PN junction becomes forward bias. Under these conditions, total conditions, holes are injected from p-type material towards V1. Injected from p-type material towards base 1. Due to this reason, the resistance is decreased and the emitter current IE is increases, because the resistance is decreases, current is increases. The resistance is decreases, the current is increases. So then the device is known in the on state, because resistance decreases, current increases. So what is the state? Resistance decreases, current increases. So this state is called as on state device. Okay, next of all, due to increase in the emitter current, so emitter current is increases in the previous point, due to emitter current is increases, a decrease in the resistance, which is known as negative resistance. Okay, because here the resistance is decreases, current is increases. Due to increase the current, decrease in the resistance, that resistance is known as negative resistance. So the characteristics of negative resistance is called as characteristics of UJT. Next we will discuss the next topic. So here the resistance is decreases, the power is increases. So the power is increased, the resistance is decreases. This resistance is known as negative resistance. Okay, if the negative voltage is applied in the previous point, here positive voltage is applied. If the negative voltage is applied to the emitter current, PN junction is in reverse. PN junction is in reverse means, so this is the p-type of material, this is the minus plus. In the condition of the negative voltage is applied to emitter, PN junction is in reverse. So the total emitter current becomes zero. In reverse condition. So this is the cutoff state. When current is zero, that is state of cutoff state. So this device is said to be off state. Okay, in the positive voltage is applied on state, the negative voltage is applied off state, this is also cutoff state.